5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you. held elections at regular intervals. With almost equal regularity, your own heart accept the verdict of the people. The true winners are, of course, the people of Sri Lanka. I'm told, Mr. President, that in your embassy here in Washington, pictures of every Sri Lanka head of government in your personal commitment to democratic ideals, Mr. President, it is a pleasure for us to have you as our guest. You underscored this heartfelt commitment. Japan should not be given its full freedom. They argued that Japan should remain shackled as a punishment for its role in World War II. As the representative of Sri Lanka, you spoke out for the President. We share your dedication to freedom and goodwill. This is more than political theory, it's a way of life. This spirit makes it natural that our two nations. Recently, we were reminded of the menace of those who seek to impose their will by force and terror. Political situation. The skill and courage that you demonstrated helped free our countrymen and at the same time prevented the terrorists from initiating. You're sharing your thoughts. You wrote, I hope that the international community will be able to eradicate the economic summit I recently attended in London. I know this sentiment is shared by the people of all the democracies. When I say the free men and women of this planet will never cower before terrorists. In your own country, as well as your efforts to find through the democratic process a peaceful resolution of communal strife. There is no legitimate excuse in a democracy. Dividing your country into separate nations, as some would have you do, is not the solution. Instead of separating people, now is the time to bring them together, yourself and the rest of the world. Mr. President, we wish you every success in your search for reconciliation and a better life for all your people. And their lives are improving. Your leadership will reap rewards for many years to come, thanks to the bold economic steps that you've taken. We're pleased that Americans are playing a part in this effort. Your endeavors to improve your people's economic well-being continues to have our solid support. Your country has vast to America.
I'm glad that Mrs. Jayewardene and I were able to accept the invitation extended by Mrs. Reagan and you. Yet already we feel we are among friends who believe and try to follow common ideals for the welfare of humans held at San Francisco. I came as my country's representative who had harmed our land and people also. That we should forgive those who were our enemies.
Those were the ideals which inspired us then and inspire us now.
For 2,500 years. There were glimpses of modern democracy even then, as in the appointment of mayors to our ancient cities.
We cannot forget the contribution made by America. Colonel Alcott, when he helped the Buddhist leaders of Sri Lanka, revival of education through schools owned and managed by the Buddhists themselves, our revolution, which freed it from foreign rule, has not been known to the land-owning territory, awesome, where freedom of speech and writing. Electing governments by universal franchise and regular equal, and the independent constitution which covers the whole of Central and South America, the whole of Africa, the whole of Asia, from the Mediterranean. The citizens and developing nations of the world receive from the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund. The program possibly unequal in magnitude. By any development program in any country in the world or earlier, and a referendum.
Thank you.
We have, however, our problems. Some of them are unique to our case, in the Eastern Front, which the United States joined to the North. The terrorists are a small group who seek terrorism from the civilized world. I was very happy, in a radio address, to the